In a previous video of Tepster's Tips, we delved into the chronology and route of human migration from Asia to populate the Americas. Today, we'll embark on a journey to uncover the southeastern route that the earliest humans followed to reach Australia. The earliest traces of human habitation in Australia are rooted in sites located within the Northern Territory, situated 150 miles to the east of the city of Darwin. Among these, the MadJedbebe rock shelter stands out as a compelling archaeological site, with widespread consensus placing its occupation by humans at approximately 50,000 years ago. A 2017 publication in the journal Nature put forth the intriguing assertion of discovering human artifacts within a soil layer that could be as old as 65,000 years. This claim, however, has encountered scrutiny from archaeological perspectives. Critics have claimed that the sandy deposits in the vicinity of the find might have facilitated the displacement of artifacts into older layers, potentially through the actions such as trampling or the activities of burrowing animals. Instead, there are multiple sources such as molecular clock estimates, DNA genetic studies, and archaeological discoveries that converge to offer substantial evidence supporting the hypothesis that the initial population of Australia by humans likely occurred approximately 48,000 to 50,000 years ago. What route did the earliest humans follow to reach Australia? Around 50,000 years ago, sea levels were considerably lower by approximately 300 to 400 feet compared to today. This lowered sea level expanded the landmass of Asia, extending as far as Java, and caused the northern coastline of Australia to move closer to Asia. However, despite these changes, significant sea gaps persisted along certain parts of the journey, some spanning up to 50 miles in width. These gaps necessitated the use of seafaring boats to successfully navigate and complete the journey. Two routes for the initial human migration into Australia have been proposed. One route entailed navigating the island chain stretching from Sulawesi to New Guinea, while others involve humans reaching northwest Australia via Timor. This remarkable journey involved individuals crossing by boat from continental Eurasia into Wallacea, an expansive set of island chains and atolls bridging the ocean gap between mainland Asia and Australia. During the Ice Ages, Australia and New Guinea, located to the east, were connected by a shallow continental shelf and formed a unified continent. Throughout Australia, many archaeological sites provide evidence of human habitation dating back over 30,000 years. These findings suggest that Australia, including its arid center and even its southern island Tasmania, was inhabited during ancient times. Regrettably, it is likely that many early human settlements situated on coastal sites have become submerged over time due to rising sea levels, remaining undiscovered and hidden beneath the ocean's depth. Among other archaeological sites, the Moyjil Site in Warrnambool, Victoria, located approximately 150 miles west of Melbourne, has been dated as far back as 120,000 years ago. This site holds remnants of shellfish, crabs, and fish that is suggestive of a refuge heap from past human or bird activities. However, the quest for definitive evidence of human occupation at this site continues, and conclusive proof remains elusive. Lake Mungo, located in the southwest of New South Wales, holds the distinction of harboring the oldest human remains in Australia. Aboriginal people have inhabited this site for a long period, with a history stretching back at least 47,000 years to this present day. Today, Lake Mungo is a dried-up lake bed. However, 50,000 years ago, Lake Mungo lakes were filled with water, providing abundant freshwater resources such as fish and shellfish, making the lakes a crucial source of food for the region's inhabitants, including Australia's earliest humans. In the realm of discoveries made at Lake Mungo, One noteworthy finding is the excavation of a Mungo woman in 1968. The remnants of this individual trace back approximately 42,000 years, solidifying it as Australia's most meticulously dated human burial. In 1974, the archaeological site yielded another significant discovery, the Mungo Man. This ancient human is widely recognized also as having an estimated age of 42,000 years, further contributing to our understanding of Australia's earliest humans that are found to date. The incredible voyage undertaken by early humans from Asia to Australia marked one of the earliest instances of humans constructing and navigating seafaring boats. This endeavor required courage as well as effective communication, showcasing our remarkable human ingenuity. Please subscribe if you like this content. In the next video of Tepster's Tips, we will delve into migration of Homo sapiens into the homelands of Homo Neanderthals, exploring the dynamics of this significant event.